guys. My name is Gustavo Sanchez. Nice to meet y'all. This is my informative speech. All right, to start off, I did want to ask y'all a question. How many of y'all drive a car here? All right, perfect. That sounds good. And I have another question for you as well. How many know how to drive a manual transmission? Not a lot, huh? Yeah. Something us millennials kind of step away from nowadays. Hard stuff and all this stuff. Jokes for y'all. So anyways, I'll be teaching y'all how to drive a manual transmission. To start off, y'all do need to learn a couple words. One of them is a clutch and a gear stick. The clutch is pretty much your leftmost pedal, the one that activates your engine and your transmission and pretty much just makes you change gears. Your gear stick will be the stick in the middle of your inside between your two seats. This is what changes your gears from first, second, third, or reverse, or whatever type of engine you have in there. A couple more words is shifting gears. It's just pretty much you shifting from first to second or third gear. RPMs, which is located on your dashboard, tells you the revolutions per minute in your engine. And stalling, one of the worst things that happens with your manual cars while you're learning your drive. It's just pretty much when your car turns off because some clutch change didn't go well or something like that. All right, now that you know your manual transmission words or vocab, first step off learning how to drive one of these cars is how to turn it on. First, to turn it on, you do have to step on the clutch and turn on the ignition. This is the only way you can turn on a manual car, and it does differ from the automatic, which you just pretty much press the key and or turn the key and it turns on. Another important thing that y'all do need to know is how many gears your car has and where they are located at. It is really important because not all of them have the same amount of gears. All right, now that your car is turned on, you do have to keep the clutch pressed. And in order for you to start driving, you do need to keep it pressed. And now you can switch it from neutral, which is in the middle, to first gear with the clutch still being pressed. With your clutch being pressed and you're in first gear now, you can actually start driving. In order for you to start moving, you do need to step on the gas. And after that, you just pretty much start letting go of the clutch slowly. It is important that you do that because your car will stall if you do not. Once you start letting go of the clutch, you will feel your car moving and you just pretty much step on the gas. After you start moving, your car is in movement. What you need to do next is pretty much start driving and start changing your gears. In order for you to change your gears, you do need to press on your clutch again around on your first gear. When you reach your first gear at 3,000 RPMs, like in the picture here, you do need to change your gear. So you press your clutch, switch to your second gear, and then press your gas again. And pretty much everything after that is repetitive. All right, braking and reversing. Anytime that you wanna reverse, it's just pretty much the same thing as going on the first gear. So you pretty much step on the clutch, put it in reverse, and start letting go of the clutch so the car can go back. And then on braking, it's really important that you press your clutch and put it into neutral. If you do not press your clutch while you are going to brake, your car will stall. So make sure to learn these as well. All right, now that y'all kind of learned how to drive a manual transmission, if one of y'all's friends go out drinking and he drinks a little too much, now y'all kind of know the basics. And let's say he's driving a manual car. Now y'all know how to kind of get an idea of how to drive one if y'all ever needed to learn. So yeah, just learn how to use your clutch and everything else and you'll start being a manual car driver.